Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a full moon reading. So I believe the full moon is on June 5th, or around June 5th, or something like that. So anyway, we're just going to do full moon reading, and we're going to see what comes up. So we are going to start right here. So what do we have for the full moon? Remember, this reading is not sign specific. This is just a message that somebody needs to hear. So what do we got for the full moon in June? It's called the strawberry moon. What do we have for the full moon? One card, please, not a whole bunch, just one. Two of Spring, a bright future manifested through hard work and creativity, partnering with others who share your dreams, great progress being made. So somebody is partnering with others. This is a partnership. This is about a partnership. This is two people working together to build up a future. So two people are coming together now or right around this full moon. These two people share the same values. They are going to be successful. This is a successful endeavor. Okay? So that is starting something new with another person. Okay? This is a bright future beginning with somebody. One card, please. There it is. Hope. Your loved ones in the spirit world know when to reach out if they see you're at a low point. Whether you're caught up in a difficult situation or struggling with someone specific in your life, there's always hope. So it looks to me like there may be some sort of power struggle. You know, there probably is, because things don't always go smoothly. But this is saying, don't give up. Don't give up. Through hard work and creativity, this will be successful. So there is two people that are working together, and they may be experiencing some times of, you know, despair, you know, or worry or something like that. And this is saying, don't give up. Don't give up prematurely, you know. Keep going. Keep going. Don't give up. So let's get one of these. Now, these cards I've had for a very long time, and I don't have no book for them. I don't know what they're called. I don't know where they came from. So, one card, please, for this full moon. The Angel of Faith. I have faith that goodness and joy are mine now and forever. So this is about having faith. So we have faith and hope in a bright future. Don't give up. Seriously. I have faith that goodness and joy are mine now and forever. This is the Angel of Faith. So, looks like this moon, this full moon, is about partnering with somebody that you may be tempted to give up on. But you are being told to go, to do it, to go through with it and follow through and don't give up. Have faith. Believe. And if you think about twos, 2-2-2 is about faith and trust. It's about choices. It's about balance. It's the beginning of foundations. There's partnership. There's a partnership where there's decisions and choices to be made that you need to make within faith and trust. Twos are soulmates. It's a soulmate number. You're on the right track. Don't lose faith, don't lose hope, and don't give up. You think about when you're building a foundation. Two's about building foundations. When you're building a foundation, you can't build it half-ass. You gotta build it strong. Ten of Wands reversed. Now the Ten of Wands reversed is a collapse. Letting go. Letting go of the need to prove yourself. Letting go of the need to do it all by yourself. Perhaps you need a little bit of help. Maybe you need to accept a little bit of help. Making a conscious change to let somebody help you, to let them in, to compromise. Four of Pentacles reversed. Now this is opening up and sharing and giving. It's time to relax. Don't worry about how much money you have. It's not all about the money. And I know a lot of people, oh my God, it's not all about the money. Yeah, no, it's not. So it's about the partnership, right? It's about building a foundation and realizing that when it's all done, the reward will be well, I'm at a loss for words, put it that way. So at the end, the reward will make you speechless, okay? It will be beautiful, okay? So anyway, I feel as though you are going to be in the midst of building a foundation with somebody that, you know, it's hard. It's hard to compromise. It's hard to let people help you. There's definitely struggling with, there's power struggles here. Okay. There's power struggles with, maybe there's money power struggles. Maybe there's, responsibilities power struggles, you know, who's doing what or who should do what and this kind of thing. Maybe you just need to communicate. You know, learn to work together, learn to compromise. Obviously, there's somebody in the spirit world that has passed away, or a guardian angel, or a spirit guide that is reaching out to you, and they can see that you're caught up in a difficult situation or struggling with someone specific. But they're saying, do not give up. Let go. These are both cards. Ten of Wands reversed and Four of Pentacles reversed are both let go. Let go of some of the responsibilities. Let go of needing to prove yourself. Let go of needing to... It's not all about the money, okay? At this point, I feel like it's about developing a bond, building a foundation. Don't worry about the money. Don't worry about the bank account. Worry about building the foundation strong and stable right now. That's the most important part. You have to build it from the bottom up. King of Cups reversed. And these cards are not reversed, you see? So, King of Cups reversed. Now this, it could be a very emotional time. Somebody may not be able to master their emotions, you know. They may not be very intuitive. They may not be very spiritual. This person may seem like they don't have good intentions. Maybe they don't have good intentions. The King of Cups in reverse is usually an individual, a person that is withdrawn, closed off emotionally, not... following their heart, not opening their heart, not emotionally available, may not be expressing their true feelings. We may have an individual. This is an individual. It doesn't matter what sign we're talking about. This is an energy. This is an individual who hasn't mastered their emotions and they are not speaking their true feelings. Or when they speak their feelings, well, they're not speaking them with... accurately. You know what I mean? They may be hiding their true feelings. They are. But this is opening up. So getting opening up. So I think we have an individual that may be opening up. Five of Wands reversed. There's an absence of... Now, this is making a conscious change. So somebody needs to make a change to open up and communicate. Now, the Five of Wands reversed is a turning point. It is. This is cooperating. So this is better in reversed. This is no more fighting. Letting go of the power struggles. I'm not playing. It's the end of conflict. It's peace. Finding peace in a situation. The Hermit. Now the Hermit reverses. It's time to reconnect. And reverse is good. It's coming out of hiding. We have an individual here that hasn't been giving their heart away or really opening their heart or protecting their heart or something like that. Maybe because they were independent for quite some time, or, you know, they're antisocial. There's antisocial here. You know, they've been in restriction because this is restriction. They've been restricted. We've been under restriction, right? But this is, it's coming out. This is so, and this is opening up, and this is socializing. Communicating. So I think there's some communication and working together that is going to be happening. This is a turning point where we're able to open up. We're able to socialize. So that period is coming. The period where it's time to reconnect and socialize is coming. It's time to come out of hiding. This period of isolation is over. We have somebody that has probably been upset. Sad. King of Cups in reverse is sad because lonely. This is loneliness. It really is. It's coming out, though. It's coming out of the restrictions. Coming out of hiding. Coming out to play. I feel like I need to grab this one. Ooh, the Lovers reversed. So the Lovers reversed is conflict, disconnection. Detaching, separation. So we might have a separation here where somebody is choosing to, you know, when you're in, somebody may be thinking about separating. You know, when you're in isolation or in some sort of restrictive situation, you have a lot of time to think. And the Hermit is about thinking. This could be like a midlife crisis. You know, somebody may be going through a midlife crisis. They've been in isolation with an individual that, you know, it's been rough. It may have been rough. You may feel like you're with the wrong one or something like that. Now, the Lover's reverse could definitely be a separation. And this could be a full-scale battle. It could go both ways. This could be peace talks. It could be cooperation. Or it could be a full-scale battle. So something is going on. We have a midlife crisis here that somebody is experiencing with another person. And I feel like there's a choice. There definitely is when the Lover's card comes out. There's a choice between two options. And I don't care if they're all reversed. And if you can say, oh, your deck is upside down, that is not the case. My deck is not upside down. There's some sort of disconnection in a partnership. And this doesn't have to be a separation. This can just be a disconnection. It could be disharmony. Because somebody isn't communicating well. This person, if we got a man or a woman, doesn't matter what sign, that is withdrawn. This person is withdrawn. They are not communicating in an emotional manner, or they're being overly emotional.
Knight of Pentacles reversed. Now this is coming, and everything, when things come out reversed, there's a reason for that. Everything happens for a reason. There's an absence of success here. When cards come out in reverse, it means there's an absence of success. So the Knight of Pentacles reversed, there could be some jealousy issues. There could be some unfaithfulness. Somebody doesn't want responsibility. They're not qualified. They don't work hard enough. They may be unemployed. Oh, we got one upright. They may be unemployed. They have no long-term plan with the Knight of Pentacles reversed. They don't finish up. They don't finish things up. They don't have any goals. There could be an ex that is in the way. Knight of Pentacles doesn't follow in reverse. Doesn't follow through. And because this person just doesn't have anything to add. So we have an individual, and they could, that may not be putting in much effort. They're giving up. And there's a disconnection. There's unfaithfulness here too as well. I feel like, or there's fear of unfaithfulness. I think there's unfaithfulness. There could be even some jealousy. This is a dropout. Somebody that drops out. Somebody is dropping out of a connection. Because it's easier to just give up, right? Seven of Wands. There's competition. There's opposition. There's fighting. There is definitely some fighting going on. There's stiff competition here. Now, this doesn't have to be romantic. This could be business related. This could definitely be business related. We could have a business that is going down. Because of this isolation, because of the restrictions that were imposed. And somebody could get the King of Cups in reverse. Somebody could get really, really upset. They can't master their emotions and they have an emotional outburst. There could be an emotional outburst because, you know, they're not getting money. They're not getting paid. You know, there's nothing coming in the bank. There's nothing going in the bank. So, you know, there could be an argument. The Seven of Wands is a fight, perhaps, or an argument. Everybody's pointing their finger. This could be the bill collectors calling. And, you know, it's overwhelming. So somebody's just like, I quit. Dropping out of this game. Done playing. Giving up. Somebody may be giving up on a partnership or a business or a job because of the isolation, you know, quitting. I'm sorry. I hate to give that kind of message, but there is an opportunity to build a better future with hard work. Everything happens for a reason. Perhaps this change, this needs to be let go because there's something better. This is fighting to be on top. It's been a constant battle to be on top. Somebody's not succeeding. I told you there's an absence of success. Somebody is not succeeding at being on top. And that's emotional. So this is a problem. That's what we got going on. Somebody is not becoming successful with being on top with all the competition because of the isolation and restrictions that have been imposed. And this person is probably going to have an emotional outburst. There could be a fight where, you know, this person... It could be a fight. I mean, we have the Five of Wands reversed and the Seven of Wands. I mean, there could definitely be a conflict, a battle of some sort where somebody just opens up and decides maybe they want to separate, they want to give up, or Ten of Swords reversed doesn't survive. That's like the worst has happened. There could be, you know, problems worsening. This is beyond help. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to scare anybody. This is a lack of survival. I'm sorry. somebody, something, it's like we have something that isn't, so it's either a partnership or, you know, it's the end. It's the end of something. Something is ending. Something is ending. There's mourning. There's grieving a loss here. I am sorry. I'm sorry. And you may hear those words. So there's grieving of a loss. I feel like, there's incompatibility. It almost feels as though there, you know, we've been having, you know, the riots and stuff. You know, you got to be careful here. You got to be careful because it feels like, you know, this is opening up. The Four of Pentacles reversed is opening up. You know, coming out of hiding. If I would stay home, put it that way. Don't leave. Right around June 5th, stay home. Stay home. Because, you know, there could be, my advice is to stay home. Oh, got it to a positive one. The Wheel of Fortune. This is positive change. Everything happens for a reason. Destiny. Karma, cycles, everything, you know, the wheel is spinning in the right direction. Something is happening. Somebody may be at the, well, I was going to say the right place at the right time. So, anyhow, it's funny because somebody's getting their cards read. This person looks a little skeptical. This tarot reader is telling them what she sees, and this person doesn't look like this person is too believing, doesn't believe. But whatever, it's funny because, but whatever they're being told is the truth. My advice is to put in effort to the partner that you are with. Don't give up. And stay home during this full moon. Good luck.